Got a richer sin than the last one, and usually you'll notice with your darker wrap cigars that they're gonna have a richer taste because of the darker wrap cigar. But it does need cut, so you need one of these. But there is an exact science to cutting these. There is not too much. Just like that. I cut a very thin sliver off. I mean, very, very thin. Okay. Let's check for draw. Draws perfectly. Okay, that is how you cut a cigar, just like that. You're gonna light a cigar, you wanna light one with the Zippo. Matches work too, but. That is pretty much how you want to toast your cigar all the way around, just like that. And that is some pretty skilled shit right there. That is how you light a cigar. Now, if you had a thing about my zodiac is though, I was born under the goat's head in the fire, so I guess you could say fire is my element. Now, normally when I do that trick, I use butane in my mouth, but that time I didn't do butane in my mouth. This has a richer flavor than last one. As you can tell, that's because generally with cigars especially, you get your darker wraps on these and they're going to be a lot richer in flavor. Not nearly as long as the last one, but it's more of a savory one. This one's actually quite delicious. I like this one. Yeah, you get a couple of good cigars. You go to like, but yeah, the cut on that, not too bad. That's generally what you want when you, look at that little bit of tobacco right there, just kind of pinch it like that, there we go. That's generally what you want when you cut a cigar, just a nice little, you know. And if it's hot enough, you can scooch the label up just a bit so you're not burning that. I managed to peel that part of the label off anyway. That's a cool looking label. I'm gonna just go like that. just gently fold it up without tearing the paper. Look at that. Nice and uniform length. There we go. That's how you can get a good cigar going, just like that. That is skill. Some people wouldn't understand it, but compared to wine tasting, you know, think of it like that, if you will. Actually, I'm just gonna take that one off too. Oh, look at that. The label came off perfectly. It didn't fall apart. It's not doing too bad. It certainly can do a little bit, but it's easily fixable. Just like that. How does he do that? Tell you what though, that's a good cigar. Things you want to watch them because you don't want to peel like too much off. But the thing about it is, these are wrapped in tobacco leaves and stuffed with tobacco. That's how you make a cigar, basically. And they're air cured and air dried in a barn somewhere. If you've seen the process and how these things are made, it's very much like a whiskey or a wine. It takes years to make. With cigars, you want a nice light like that. Dadash. No, that's not originally my content, but whatever. Cigar right here. Yeah, the first one was alright, but this one I like a lot better. That's the fun of trying cigars, is, you know, seeing which ones, you know, taste like what. And you're thinking it's just a cigar. They all taste the same. You haven't tried a cigar, and I would not recommend it if, you know, your first cigar. I would not recommend inhaling. If you're not used to that kind of thing, you will cough like a mofo. I'm just saying. However, to each of their own, right? Ooh. Yeah. That's pretty good stuff right there. And a light on that. Nice. Round is what you're looking for. It's a perfectly cut cigar, in my opinion. That's what you want to look for if you're cutting it. Some people cut too much, some people cut too little, and it's just like, eh. That right there is a perfect cut. both of you to the cigar smoking. General rule of thumb, each cigar is going to be wrapped in a tobacco leaf, and that wrap gets dried longer depending on how sweet you want the cigar, how rich you want it. So you go into a shop and you don't know what you're looking for. It's simple shit, really. Dark ones are richer, light ones not so rich, but more mellow and, you know. So, yeah. I like that's what you would like to see in your cigar. Yes, uniform light. We got some nice candles on the altar there that basically mask the scent of cigar, because I reckon people aren't going to be a fan of it. Whatever. Yeah, that's got a nice flavor to it. Tap it like that lightly into the ashtray, and look at that, it's still going, and still nice even light. Minutes in, and this thing is not even close to done. So you can see these things obviously take a lot longer to finish than a whole cigarette, which is why normally when people smoke, you know. That's just the rule of thumb for any cigar, whether you see it in a cigar shop or in a grocery store, and you see them in a little display case or whatever. General rule of thumb is your darker papered cigars are going to be richer than your lighter colored ones, as far as flavor and intensity, you know. And it varies on cigars, really. That's what makes trying one, you know, it's like sampling a wine, just like I said, because there's different flavors of wines, right? Step closer to getting that beach because you're done. To reassemble the sprocket and all that onto a different rim because the old rim broke riding at home one day, obviously, so I got that taken care of. Once that's all set and done, you know, I'm getting that chain assembly on and everything, but it's getting there one step at a time. Take one thing, those candles right now combined are outpowering the cigar scent. Ain't that something? I believe there's a song by the band Pink Floyd called Have a Cigar. I would play it, but YouTube might flag me on infringement. I'm going to risk silencing the audio. The nice thing about cigars is like a cigarette. If you want to stick out the inner string, they put itself out, then yes, but there is a proper way to ash a cigar and just, you know, you could break the leaf. So. Press in your string, twist it in a circle back and forth, flatly against your string, tap it twice, maybe 3, 4, 5, 6 times lightly. It's still going. If you wanted to, you can probably let that sit out in your ashtray, just, you know. But even after all that, you can see it's still lit, so yeah, that's a quality cigar right there. So you could probably just let it sit in your ashtray and let it put itself out. She doesn't want to go out, so you can finish it or whatever. Yeah, if you were to soak this in some of this Jim Beam honey rum before you lighted it, it'd put it back in the wrapper. Let it humidify like that. Oh, that'd be a damn good cigar. This taste combination I'm getting right now is quite tasty indeed. about that. Still going. Oh, yeah. That made a damn good cigar. Enough to wet the paper with the rum, or no, the rum, excuse me, the whiskey. There's enough to wet whiskey in a cigar, just enough to keep the cigar a little moisture, so it, yeah, there's a bit of an art form to it. It may taste just a little sweeter. A little better. And you don't have to do this part, but me, I'm like, yeah, no, this fucker's not gonna fall apart on me. So, yeah, that's pretty much half a cigar right there, and it takes about 29 to 30 minutes, so you're looking at a good hour just to sit there and smoke this entire thing. And it's still going. best way to put that kind of cigar out would be just set it on its ash and let it put itself out. It will eventually. It's not receiving the minimum draw just to puff on it and what have you. Yeah, that takes a minute to finish. And it's just like, oof. That's a rich cigar, too. And letting it put itself out, it'll just dry out that rum, or excuse me, that whiskey soaking into it. This is King Cobra JFS with another video, and thanks for watching.